Let us discuss overriding parameters or parameterized modules. Before getting into what parameterized modules are, let us say we are trying to write a counter, 3-bit up counter. So, if you look at line 4 for 4-bit up counter, what we do is 3:0, that is a vector size. So this counter is now meant for only for 4-bit up counter. Means this logic elsewhere you cannot instantiate, so that by making some alternations in that, you can make it this counter workable for any bit counter, any number of bit counter. So if you look at line 2, we have used a keyword parameter space n equal to 2, then terminating with a semicolon. Now this n is used in line number 4, n-1:0 for vector declaration. So this is perfectly working, this parameter keyword. What it does is that n identifier has been assigned with 2 in this current module, and that 2-1 anywhere within the module, if n is encountered, then that n will be replaced by 2. So this is how this current module is. Okay, now this current module I can use elsewhere. This current module is for only 2-bit up counter. By making use of this kind of description, that is using a parameter description, elsewhere I can instantiate this counter module and I can make it workable that as a any bit counter, not necessarily a 2-bit up counter, 3-bit up counter, it could be 4-bit up counter, any bit counter. So that is what parameterized modules or parameterized module means. Now let us proceed to next slide. In this slide, you can see a counter underscore para underscore 1 is a module in a line number 1. If you look at line number 3, it's a 4:0, means 5-bit counter up. Okay, but you don't see any logic here that is describing a 5-bit up counter behavior. Instead, the parameterized module earlier in the slide 1, what we have described, that module is been instantiated here. But the difference what you see in line number 4 is not only simply instantiation with the instantiation name C2, in between module and instantiation name, module name and instantiation name, you see hash within parenthesis 5. So this is how you redeclare that parameter n equal to 2 there in the first slide with this 5. This is how Verilog facilitates us to override that parameter value. So now this module is working as a 5-bit up counter, provided that counter what we have instantiated is present in the current working directory. Moving on to the next slide, there we will show this another approach how we can override the parameter. here in this line number 1, if you look at counter underscore para underscore 2, this is another module. Look at line number 4. You see there one keyword DEFPARAM, meaning define parameter. That is the keyword. Space C1. C1, if you look at line number 5, it's the instantiation name for that counter. C1 dot N. N is a identifier in that parameterized module. Counter is a parameterized module. In the slide 1, what we have shown. So C1 dot N is assigned with 16. So this way, if you do, this also overrides that N value in a parameterized module, as you have seen in slide 1. This is another approach to override the parameter. Here as well, you see line number 3, 15 colon 0 means it's a 16 bit up counter, but you don't see the logic here. Simply we are instantiating the parameterized module counter, line number 5, and then instantiation name, that's it. So how is that we are going to override? If you look at line number 4, define parameter DEFPARAM is a keyword. With the help of that keyword, we are overriding that. So there are two approaches, as you have seen in this previous slide, method 1 and this method 2. Hope you understood what is parameterized module means. Same thing you can apply for shift registers as well. Suppose say 4 bit left shift register we are defining or describing a parameterized module. Later on we are in need of writing 32 bit left shift register. So if you could able to write a 4 bit or 2 bit a parameterized shift register, then that can be a while to override the parameter and then write according to our own requirement. Okay, hope you will try this one. Thank you. Thank you.